welcome. Nice to have you here. Thank you for joining us. There you are. You've worked in the round before. Right. Hold on a second. Daryl, would you be kind enough, please, to introduce these first two gentlemen, and then we'll catch the others on the other side.
Okay, sure. Here we got, on bass, we have T-Bone Walk.
Nice to have you with us. Thank you. On drums. Stand up, sir, so the whole family can see.
Got Mickey Wipeout Curry on drums.
Thank you, sir, very, very much. All right, John, you got the honors over here.
Son, lead guitar, G.E. Smith.
Nice to have you with us, sir. And?
And on saxophone and keyboards, Charlie, Mr. Casual Duchamp.
Is that your baby? You got to tell her she likes Daddy best of all. I mean, I gave her the perfect lead-in. That's a cute kid. All right, now tell the truth. You two guys are from Philadelphia. You were born and brought up there. Why didn't you come to the bandstand when you were kids? I've been waiting a long time to find out the answer to this question. There isn't a soul who grew up in Philadelphia didn't come to this show. Where were you?
I was too young, dude.
is that the truth, really? Were you underage at that time?
I think I'm still underage.
How long have you two known each other?
About 12 years now.
This is a peculiar question. Did you know each other musically or as friends before you started this?
No, we went to school together first, so we were friends first, and then we decided to get together about 3 years after we met.
Here's a question you can't answer. Why have you had so many hits?
I don't know. I'd like to think it's because we're making the music we want to make and it sounds right to us.
There are people, other people have said it easier because it may be embarrassing to you to say that, but you're the music makers of the 80s. You found the key. Do you keep in touch with people? I mean, are you aware of what's going out on the street so that you tune your heads that way?
We live in New York, so we hear it on the street all the time. But, we listen. We don't listen too much to the radio, but we hear it. You can never get away from it when you're in New York.
Where do you make your music?
In New York, in the Village. We both live in the Greenwich Village, and we record at Electric Lady Studios in the West Village.
Why do you produce your own albums now?
Well, we really got tired of sort of translating our creative ideas through other people, and we have a band now that we really like, and the guys play the right thing, and we just go in and make the music. It's much easier now.
We'll talk again in the second half hour. Can we do another song?
Sure.
What's it going to be?
No Can Do.
Oh, we got it. All right. Daryl Hall and John Oates. A thing of beauty it was. It's beauty. When we last left off, we were talking about living in New York, recording at Electric Lady and all of that. Why do you record at the same place all the time?
It's got a good feeling.
Close to their house.
You like the beat? It's easy to get to. No. Is that really?
Close to the house. It's close to where they live. That's why.
Is it really true?
Yeah, it's 2 blocks from my house and 4 blocks from his house. So.
That makes it easy.
Saves on transportation. Now, are you superstitious?
About recording, you mean?
Yeah.
No, not really.
You ever worry that you'll come up dry and then you won't go in there and make hits?
I don't know anything about hit records. We just make the best records we can, and if they're hits, great.
What time of day do you work?
Usually in the afternoon.
What happens then? You go in to make a record. You have an idea in mind, and what goes on, say, from what, noon to five? Or yeah.
We start by with the band, and we cut rhythm tracks, and then from there on, we eat lunch. And then
is that the hard part? Is it the most physically difficult?
Yeah, actually, yeah, physically. Other than the lead vocals, that's definitely hard. Yeah.
Do you record at night ever?
Usually when we're singing, we do, because it's easier to sing at night than it is during the day.
Nobody wants to get up in the morning and croak a lot there. This is, I don't mean this to be a downer question, but we were talking about it before the show went on. You were so hot, you were so successful, you had 10 or 11 straight top 10 hit records. Do you ever worry about the day when you'll put one out there and it'll go...
Yeah, sure.
Are you prepared for that day? Is it got to happen?
Well, we like to think that we are. You never are really prepared for it, but it's... I mean, we make music for other reasons. I mean, we want to make a lot of money, sure. You know, that's fun. Yeah. But it's... I think we've been making music most of our lives, and I think there's other things that are more important. The commercial success is great, but it's not the only thing that we're working for.
Are you going to tour?
Yeah, in fact, this is almost the beginning of the tour. We leave for England right after this, then Japan, then Australia, and then back.
How about here at home? When will we see you out on the road again?
Right after the beginning of the new year, 83.
Look forward to it.
February.
What are we going to hear now?
What are we going to hear? Yeah, Family Man.
Do you always carry him through? You carry him through like this. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, Daryl Hall and John Oates.